How are you today? Have you had a great week? I hope you have. I hope you've learned lots at school. Well, this week is a really interesting week for our kids' church story. So to introduce it, Lucy and I thought we would take a wee bit of a road trip round to the church to see what's going on in our church building, because you haven't been in it for ages. Neither have I, and neither have most of the people, so maybe it'll become clear whenever you see pictures. You probably know, I'm sure your folks have told you about it. But I wanted to show you just what the new bit of the church building was going to look like, and Lucy was very excited to see it too. So you'll see us starting off on our journey, and then you'll see us in the middle of Ballybean looking at the new church building. But here's what I want you to think about. After you see the building of the video that I took, there's going to be the story, and it's about the church. But I want you to think about something. When you're watching the video of the church, I want you to think about what actually is the church. Is it maybe the bricks and the doors and the windows and the lovely colours that you'll see in the video that I took of our church? Or is it something else? Is it something even better than our new building? So have a wee think about that while you're watching the video. What actually is the church? You'll have to listen very carefully, okay? Do that, and then come back to me and we'll have a chat about it. Enjoy.
Lucy, stop barking. Are you very excited? You sit down in your wee bed. We're going on a drive and we're going to visit our new church building. Lucy, you're so excited. You can't speak to me. Look at me. Hey you, what do you think? Would you like to go for a drive? Would you? A wee drive? Let's do that. Oh, look at that, Lucy. Look at our new front to our building. Isn't it nice? I hadn't seen it without all the scaffolding. I think you and me need to get out of the car. And Lucy, will we go for a walk? Will we do that? Let's go for a walk. So there's the big skip with all of the rubbish that's come out of St. Mary's and the renovations. I imagine that's only one of many skips, but look, this is the business, isn't it? Look at our front entrance, that's all changed, hasn't it? Oh, Lucy's pulling me the other way. Lucy, come on, right up to the door. Lucy's modelling. Ooh, look at that, isn't that like St. Mary's Church? And then we've got all of those coloured bricks that match our stained glass window, aren't they nice? And what's through here? I wonder, can we see? You can't really see with the reflections. Hard to see, isn't it? You can't really see through it, but it looks like a lovely big new foyer. There's Ballybean. And there's where our church is, in the middle of Ballybean. Let's go round the side and show you the side of the building. Sorry, my camera skills aren't great. But we can go down here because there's another great big window in the middle of a very bright red wall. Look at that, isn't that nice? We've got a nice bright church for people to notice and come to. And there's the bricks again on the window. Very nice. Do you approve? What do you think of our new bit that juts out? And that's only one bit to look at, because there's more inside that has changed. Let's just go around here. There's a big skip, it's a bit of an eyesore. Hopefully that won't be there. I'm showing you this because very soon our church family are going to be back
in the new church building with all of the nice new stuff in it, and it'll look all different inside. And you will soon be back in kids' church, like in real life. So we won't need kids' church on YouTube anymore, because it'll be real life kids' church, just like it always was, right back to normal. And you'll be coming through, we don't know, you might come through that door, you might come through the other door that you usually come through. That's to be decided, I don't know, maybe this one. Anyway, there's the new church building, very nice. And where has Lucy gone? She's gone exploring. So I'm going to take her a walk, like I promised, around the church building. Lucy, we'll go for a walk? Yeah, okay.
Have you ever wished you had a certain talent or gift? Maybe you wish you were a brilliant scientist, or a world-famous singer, or a gold medal-winning basketball player. Those are all good gifts. But sometimes, no matter how much we practice or how hard we try, we just won't have all the gifts we want. But that doesn't mean we don't have special gifts of our own. We all play an important role in the body of Christ, also known as the church. And God's given all of us gifts to help. The Apostle Paul talks about this in the book of 1 Corinthians. He said to think about it like this. In our human body, our eyes and our feet were made to do very different things. Our eyes were made to see, and our feet were made to walk. If our eyes and our feet decided to change places, how would we see? How would we walk? Our bodies wouldn't work very well. The body of Christ is the same way. God's given us our special gifts as part of His church. When we use those gifts well, the whole body of Christ works like it should, to show God's love to each other and the world. But when we don't use our gifts or get jealous and wish we had different gifts, it's like we're an eye wishing we were a foot. God made you to be you, with your own unique and special mix of gifts and talents. So think about how you can use the gifts He's given you to follow Jesus and serve others as part of the church. When you do that, you'll be true to the self God made you to be.
So, did you enjoy the video? Did you have any ideas? Did you talk to your folks about it, or your granny, or whoever's minding you this morning? I hope you did. What do you think? Is the church just the building? It's not, sure it's not. Think about what we've been through over the last year. We have still been a church, but we haven't had a building to go to, except for the Methodist. Who lent us their building, but for a long time we didn't have a building, and for a long time people weren't allowed to come together. Sure they weren't, but we were still the church, because the church is the people in it. And more importantly, the church is made up of people who belong to God, people who have given their lives to God, and people who have asked Him for His forgiveness. And if that's you, then that is you, part of the church as well. And I just wanted you to remember, number one, that we're going back to St. Mary's soon, and we are so excited, and it's going to be great to see like all the new stuff that's inside. I don't even know, I can't even tell you what to expect. But there'll be like maybe a new layout inside, and when you go through that door that we took the video off, it'll all be new and exciting and shiny and bright, and we're all excited, and it's great. And God has been really good in helping us to pay for all of that. But I want you to know, and I want you to remember, that when you walk into our new building very soon and go, wow, look at this, it's amazing, this is gorgeous, I'm so glad I'm part of St. Mary's, that the church is the people walking into that building. Okay, what we've got now is a lovely building for the church to enjoy, for the family of God to enjoy, but also, and very importantly, for people who aren't part of God's family to come into and enjoy and feel welcomed in and feel safe in and feel that they can get help in from the church, from the people who love God, from the people in the building who have given their lives to God and want to follow Him. And part of that is for in their love for others and in their love for people who don't belong to God, who would come into our church, and to invite people to our building to meet the church inside who are really friendly and love God and care about others. So I am excited to get into our new building. Yes, it's gorgeous. But you know what I'm really excited about? I'm really excited about meeting with the Church of God again in our new building and all of my friends and family. The Bible says that we are family. If you belong to God, then we are all brothers and sisters and we are all family together. And the other thing I want you to remember is that you are important. If you belong to Jesus and if you love Him and you're seeking to follow Him every day and you've given your life to Him, you are part of the church and you are important. And it said in the video, didn't it, that we all have different gifts. What's my gift, I hear you say? Well, I don't really know what all of mine are. I could maybe tell you a couple of gifts that I think I might have. But you have to think about your own gifts. And here's a starting point. What are you really passionate about? What do you love? What are you good at? What do you think about lots? What do you think is just in your nature to do and to be? Maybe you're really friendly. Maybe you're really good at baking. Maybe you are musical. You like music. Maybe you just love to read the Bible and you love to tell others about the Bible. Maybe you love to pray. You could have any number of gifts given to you by God. And if you are part of God's family, you're part of the church, and your gift and how you use it is really important. So know this, you're important and you need to pray about it and you need to think about, well, what could my gifts be? And you've got to use them for God inside our beautiful building as part of His people, as part of His church. So let's look forward to the new building. Let's look forward to Kids Church being in person again very soon, actually. So that'll be good fun. But mostly, let's be thankful to God that we are part of His church and we get to gather together in that lovely new building that He has provided for us as His church, who look up to God and who reach out to others, because that's what Jesus wants us to do. Jesus wants us to be His hands and His feet, just like a body. We are the body of Jesus. We are the church of God. And we have to do our part and use our different gifts and enjoy them and be thankful for them. So remember that. And remember our value, because we all have different gifts, don't we? We don't all have the same one. That was in the video as well. So you need to think about, well, what could my gift be? And pray about it. Ask God to show you, what has He gifted me with? What am I good at? What do I love? What is my passion? Talk to your folks about it. And that's a really good place to start, to think about what your gifts are and how you can use them inside our church building. So you remember that? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you that you have given us different gifts. Thank you that you invite us to use them for you. And thank you for the privilege of being part of your family and part of your church. And thank you, Father, that we have got a beautiful new building for our church to meet in and to show love to one another and love to the community that you love so much. Help us to find our place in it and help us to glorify you in our new building. In Jesus' name, Amen. Who is good? God is good. All the time. Let's say it again, you ready? God is good. No, it was my turn, wasn't it? All the time, God is good. Have a lovely week. And remember that even though we're not in St. Mary's building at the minute, we are still the Church of God. And we still belong to Jesus. And it'll be just great to see each other again, won't it? In 3D, in real life. Have a lovely week. Bye.
Go! And then hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please share with a friend or subscribe to our channel so that we can make more fun dance videos. Bye!